Good morning, Anne. Morning, guys. How's everyone this morning? Awesome, you guys. We're gonna get started. We got a couple things to do today. Some upper body strength work, followed by a 16-minute, 2-minute EMOM. Every 2 minutes out of the 2 minutes, you do a thing. So let's take a look at it, chat about it, and then we'll get moving. Here's what the workout is today. We've got 3 to 5 rounds, 8 to 15 reps. We'll talk about the reps when we get to the lifting stuff. Of bicep curls, tricep extensions, and a dumbbell pullover. Then we have 8 rounds of every 2 minutes on the 2 minutes you do 20 mountain climbers, 10 single arm kettlebell deadlifts per side, and 5 kettlebell cleans. So let's flip this around. Pretzel saying hi. Sit down. Sit. Speak. Pretzel. Speak. Speak. Good boy. Okay. All right. Yes, Pretzel. Good boy. He's licking my phone. Okay. No. Not the phone. Let's see if that works. Yes. All right. So we can get started. We don't need to do too much to get loose. I was going to do a set of mountain climbers, then just kind of a full body stretch, then some arm specific stuff, and then we'll get right into our lifting things. So we're going to go 30 seconds on, 15 seconds off of mountain climbers. A couple ways you can do them. Ways to do it. You guys are going to come down. You can either come all the way outside. If you've got some back things going on for some people, whether or not you've had any back injuries in the past, some people find this just running mountain climbers to be better. Either way you want to do it, we're going to go for 30 seconds. 3, 2, 1, go. Just moving. You can step it. Just step it in. Step it out, side your hands, whatever works for you. You got 10. Three, two, and one. Take 15 seconds. We got one more round of that. Go 5, 3, 2, 1. Let's get it. Doesn't need to be fast, just wake up your body. Whew. 15 seconds. Later. All right, you're gonna touch your toes, count to 2, stand up, right arm back, left arm back, touch your toes, right arm back, left arm, a couple more times, oh, it looks so nice outside today, hope you guys can get out, get some sun. More. Give yourself some hugs. So I'm just going straight out the arms. I'm going to go angles. I'm going to go the other side. So whatever hand is on top up here is the one that's on top down below. Shake it out. And then just some full body stretches real quick. Make sure I'm in the camera. There we go. So I'm just going to walk it down. Come on down in the front. I'm going to put my right foot outside of my right hand. Up and down. The Chris Wood special, I call this sometimes. Then I'm going to stand up. I'm actually going to stand, shorten my stance. Sit back. And back leg can be straight or bent. Stretch out the front hamstring. I'm going to come back down. I'm going to actually walk my hands back to my feet. Keep your, let your knees straight. And then come up. Other side. Hands to the floor. Walk it forward. Down dog. There we go. And then left foot outside of your left hand. Chris Wood special. And then we stand up, shorten the stance, bring it in, stretch out that front leg. Come on down, and back. Hands to your feet, and come on up. Good, take a seat. Just gonna go two times, we're gonna go five reverse tabletops, followed by 10 scapular push-ups. So the first time, fingertips point toward you. Just lift up, hold, and then down. Up and hold, and down. Three, four, and there's five. Flip over. Some scapular push-ups. 10, nice and controlled. Neck in line with your spine. Make sure that back's not sagging down. There's 10. And then we've got one more set. Whichever way your fingertips were, I think mine were facing in, so I'm gonna go out this time. If your fingertips were facing in before, put them out, just switch it up. Can't remember what I did now. Maybe I was already that way. There we go. And there's 5, 10 straight arm push-ups. Nice and controlled. Good. Come on up. Okay, so first set, I'm going to try to get through 5 rounds. We'll see how that goes. Bicep curls, tricep extensions, and dumbbell pullovers. A lot of you guys have a single dumbbell. If you don't have a dumbbell, you can use anything for this. A gallon of water, a jug of water, for some of my ladies, even a very full water bottle. Sometimes it's not about how much you're lifting, especially when we're in these interesting times. It's just about moving and doing something. So even if you guys are using a soup can or an Nalgene bottle or a quarter gallon of milk, any of those things work. So use what you have. So I'm fortunate to have a few dumbbells, so I'll actually be switching it up. But if you only have one dumbbell and it's too heavy to do your bicep curls, do them just two-handed, like this. Okay. So you'll see me do one-hand ones, but if that doesn't work for you, just two hands. Pretzel's barking at something. I don't know what it is. All right, so here we go. I'm going to go for, I've got probably 5 to 8 on this. Somewhere between 8 to 15 is what we said. But scale that down if the weight is heavy, making sure that your body is not moving. I think I'm gonna do sets of 5 with this. That's pretty heavy for me. So if you feel like you're starting to swing because it's really hard, don't do that. You can even stand against a wall. Anything you need to do, keep yourself stable. If you feel like that elbow's coming back like this to get it up, don't. Try to keep it steady. Just moving the weight. I think that was five. Okay. Tricep extensions. Lots of ways you can do these. I'm gonna go over the head, extending from the back, with the weight in between my hands. So I'm gonna use that one weight. Notice that I'm holding it like this. So hands are around there. Put it above my head. Here I like to use is biceps by your ears. And then just come back and down. Somewhere between that 8 and 15 range. I'm going to go to 8 on my first set. I'm going to raise it up as we go on. Next one's the one that gets a little interesting. This depends on what you have for a setup. I should have mentioned before, a chair. Probably going to need a chair, like a folding chair. I'm going to show the folding chair. Probably going to use a bench on how to do some dumbbell pullovers. So, I should have tried this before I did it. I'm going to get my shoulders on the chair. There we go. So, I'm actually going to, kind of like I'm doing a glute bridge. So I'm going to go shoulders on the chair, like this, since I need my weight. Start with the weight, make sure you can get to that position. Once you do, just kind of shimmy yourself down so your neck is supported. And then, dumbbells in hand, just like the grip with the tricep extension, I'm just going to come down. I'm going to pull back up. So I'll do the first set on the chair. You'll see me switch to a bench. Boxes work even better for this. If you have a bench, you can lay on the bench instead of doing a modified glute bridge to support yourself. Again, remember, do what works. Use what you got. Questions, let us know. I lost count. I'm going to do two more. There we go. Okay. There. Okay. So that's one set. I'm going to take, should be good doing four more. So I'm just going to start going through the exercises. I'll say what I'm doing, but I'm not going to talk as much. And I'll take about probably up to 15 minutes just to get through these sets. Yeah, take a little rest in between your rounds. Turn clock on. That works. And here we go. Round two. Full extension all the way down on your dumbbell curls. All the way down, all the way up. Dumbbell curls are something that when I work with clients, I pretty much never program, but I would never say I will never use them. Every once in a while, there's a time and there's a person where this actually is where their weakest part is. I've had a couple of ladies who we've been working on pull-ups, and they're really close. And it's interesting because you'll watch the pull-ups, and you realize that the weakest link is, it's not the lats, which is common, but it's actually just their biceps. So I've had two ladies in the last year, I've actually had to do some bicep curls to improve their pull-ups, and it's worked. So I will never say I never use things. I just use them less because it's less common that I find people needing them, but when they do, that's what they're there for. Should be good. So I'm going to switch to my bench instead of the chair.
Should I move it forward? Again, you guys don't need to follow along with me right now. Go at your own pace. I'm gonna try to get through four more sets. There's two sets done. Shake it up. Take 30 seconds of rest. These lat pullovers, or dumbbell pullovers, these are a great exercise to develop that lat strength that so many of us need to develop to improve or get pull-ups. That's for the ladies. For the guys, they're just kind of a fun exercise. All right. Moving on to round three. Scale the number of reps. It's relative to what you have available in weight. I know it says 8 to 15. That's probably a little much for me with my weight. Dumbbell pullovers. Go as low as you can with that weight. Again, if you've got a heavier weight, you might have a compromised range of motion. In the gym, we'd probably lighten the weight, depending on what the goal is. And increase the range of motion. At home, you might not have that ability. That's okay. Whew. You'll feel that tomorrow. Take a minute. That was round three. I got two more. I'm sitting in here and I just hear Pretzel like run around outside, and then he barks, and he's running, and then he comes in and there's like mud all over his face. I don't want to know. Right now I'm watching him hopefully not dig. Pretzel, come, come. Sit. Round four. What you doing? What are you doing out there? Who's out there? Who's out there? We got one more. Ooh, yes, Pretzel. Pretzel, come here, right? Sit. Okay, go sit. Oh, there's five. Ten dips this time. Nine. And then we'll do our pullovers. Again, if you guys have a bench for these, you don't need to do them the way I'm doing. You can actually lie down on your bench. I'm just doing it for this, for demonstrative purposes. Either way though, works fine. So you can lie down on your bench like you normally would do these two. Okay, we got one more round. Let me give my arms a little rest. Doing okay on time. And then we'll get to our EMOM. Oh, it's just beautiful outside today. Here we go, last set. Ten. Last 10 here. And feel all that. Feels pretty good. Okay, so we got an 8 minute, moving on. Every 2 minutes on, 2 minutes, 20 mountain climbers, each leg. 10 single arm kettlebell deadlifts, each side. 5 kettlebell cleans. So we've already done some mountain climbers. You can either do kind of a standard mountain climber. Where you actually bring your foot outside of your hand, it comes all the way up, that's fine, or you can do a running sort of mountain climber. Any back stuff, even if you haven't had any back stuff, I recommend the running version of it. If the number is too many for you, if you kind of get into it, like, wow, 20 is a lot, which it is, just break it, cut it down in half. Even if you sit down, if you get down and you do one on each side and then you move on, that's great. Okay, so part two, the second exercise is gonna be our deadlift. You're just picking up anything off the ground. So if you're with us and you have weights, the idea was to use your kettlebell. If the kettlebell doesn't work for this, you can always use your dumbbell. Generally, our folks have lighter dumbbells than they do kettlebells.
recommending a sumo stance for your deadlift, so kind of a wider stance, so that the kettlebell is actually between your legs, like this, versus on the side, but either one, again, do what works for you. So, put this right here. So I'm gonna take that sumo stance, I'm gonna be right here, I'm just gonna lift and lower 10 times. That's our sumo, or our single arm kettlebell deadlift. I'm gonna put this hip box underneath. I'm not sure how that's gonna work, especially not right there. So I'll come up here with it. Yeah. Okay. You got that. Then we've got our kettlebell cleans. When we do cleans, usually I have you guys warm up with a lighter kettlebell. Not gonna happen today. So we're gonna take the thumb points down, okay? Thumb points down. I'm gonna pop my hips, shrug my shoulder, and then pull back and punch up, okay? So I'm here, I'm gonna pop, shrug your shoulder, elbow back, and punch it up. That's all the movements of it with my kettlebell. I'm here, I'm gonna pull back and up. The reason I'm so big about that is what you're not doing is a swing. So I'm not having you do any kettlebell swings because I don't want to see that kettlebell come all like that and just bang your forearm or the belly. So just a little pop and punch up. If the kettlebell that you have doesn't work or you don't have a kettlebell, dumbbells are a fine alternative for this. So with our deadlifts, you can either do them this way, you can do them this way, and then for the cleans, just dumbbell hang power cleans. Per side, 5 per side. All right, I'm gonna grab a drink. My clock will be set. You should be able to get through this and have like 30 seconds of rest. So if you find that you're not, I don't know if I will, use the first round to kind of judge. If you get through that first round and you have like no rest time, cut the number of something, whether you take your mountain climbers from 20 to 10 or 20 to 15, or your single arm kettlebell deadlifts from 10 to 5, some kind of a rep scheme so that you have that rest. Otherwise, this is going to be 16 minutes. It's going to be kind of rough. So, let's get music going first. A little bit at least for me. Okay. So here we go. Mountain climbers. 3, 2, 1, go. Sweatshirt on. 30 seconds. It's gonna be good. One down, 7 to go. Layers are coming off. We got 10 seconds. Round 2 starts. Go. What?
can't even get my butt all over. Don't want to know what he's digging in. Here we go. 10 seconds. 5. All right, 10 seconds. Let's get through these reps. 5, 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Thank you. I don't know what the hardest part is. Just kind of like going through, not stopping. All right, second half. Let's get it, guys. 3, 2, 1. Here we go. Notice myself on those mountain climbers. My hips are coming up. Try to keep them down, myself included. Alright, guys, we got 3 more. Keep up your pace. Whatever that is, let's do it. And 5. A little sprint. Here we go. 3, 2, 1, go. Hips down as much as you can. Thank you.
guys. I don't know what you want. Two. 5 seconds. Last round, pretzels. Last one. Ready? 3, 2, 1. Let's go. So go ahead. Go. 2 gloves. My hands get sweaty. Whew. Okay, pretzel. Come. Yes. Don't lick me, you're gross. So he goes in mud. That's his new thing. Yesterday, today, he's been digging in mud. And he gets it all over his face. He comes in, there's mud everywhere. No, don't let me. Let me see. Yeah, it's all muddy. Oh, no, oh, okay. That's all. All right. Thanks for the workout. Thank you for the workout. That was. Why'd that beep? Yeah. That was great, you guys. Starting over. All right. Awesome. It's gorgeous outside. It's gorgeous outside, you guys. I'm going to cool down with a nice walk. Might do some hamstring stretches of some sort once I get back in. Maybe later. One more thing, you guys, is later on, if you take, there it is. For the biceps, this whole line, this anterior line, just give you some pass-throughs. Maybe a couple right now, maybe a couple later in the day when you're working, and also a little bit of lat stuff. Might feel really good. Whew, that's nice. After all the stuff we did. Anyway, have a great day, you guys. There's a email coming out soon to everybody about stuff. Just nothing big, just some new things we're going to be doing to keep us all together, engaged, working out. Yeah, watch for that, and I will see you later, tomorrow, later, one of the two. Bye, guys.